episode number 9 with Jacquelynn Watson from beautiful Freshwater Northern Beaches.
Spot.
What an awesome spot.
Covered some good suburbs today. Byron, Ballina.
Have you got the surfboard? You're a Bondi.
You're a Bondi.
Good morning.
Hey, Jacquelynn Watson. Good morning. Welcome
to
the mentor. Hey, we're really well. How are you?
Yeah, good, thank you.
We were just talking to another agent up in Ballina near Byron Bay, and now we're talking to you at the beautiful part. You're in Freshwater, right?
Yes, the Northern Beaches.
God's country, Jack.
And then we're coming to you. And then we're coming to you from Bondi Beach. So Matt and I said we might as well go surfing today. We're talking to everyone who's on the beaches.
It's all good.
So Jacquelynn, tell us
Everyone loves the beach.
Everyone loves the beach. Absolutely. Yeah. So Jacquelynn, just give us a little bit about you, your marketplace, where you work. Give us a little quick bio.
Yep, absolutely. So I work at Ray White. Freshwater. I've been with Ray White for a couple of years now, but overall I've actually been in the industry for 17 years. So I've seen quite a lot of different markets. I predominantly do mum and dad homes. So the family home, if you know what I mean, couple of kids around Mandevale, Allambie Heights, those areas. It's a great market, great community. As you know, the last few years, the listings have been quite tight and the market was very, you know, didn't have a great deal of property to sell, and it was quite competitive, and a lot of agents would win the business by just really discounted fees or cover marketing, and it was very interesting.
We've seen a lot of that, haven't we, Matt, in the last 12 months? Yeah, go on.
So what I feel now is that there has been a slight shift in the market. It's not a bad market by any stretch of the mile. I think it's actually quite a normal market, if you know what I mean. I think the last couple of years have been abnormal. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's not what I was used to.
No,
totally.
I mean, it was welcoming because it was quite easy. I think it also, what I found was in my area, which is quite competitive, a lot of younger agents who'd only had a couple of years experience who weren't being shadowed by anybody, they just kind of entered the market, would pick up quite a bit of the business, and the properties sold for quite a lot of money. So, you know, everyone was kind of happy.
Yep.
What I've noticed now, though, is with the shift in the market, more so than ever, you actually need to have the experience behind you, because I feel now that you've got to really work with the buyer.
Yes.
To get the buyer to a point to see value in a property. And I think a lot of those skills come with experience.
Yep.
So my question for both of you, which seems like an unusual question, but there's two parts to this question, is without coming across arrogant, and given that there are so many different places out there where an agent advertises themselves, whatever platform it might be, through the internet, you know, social media, What can you do to, or what should you be doing with a vendor, or what would you do now to say or really bring home to people that the difference between, say, someone that hasn't got experience could be quite a substantial amount of money on your results, and how do you advertise that so that you can kind of, you know, step up to the mark? And because, like, I've just noticed some of the results with people who haven't seen this kind of market where you've got to really negotiate, which they've probably never had to do in their life.
Yeah.
I've noticed their results seem to be not as good as it could be, if that makes sense. And I look at where you advertise your experience and what you would say to vendors about coming on board, and they're just, it's very overwhelming with the amount of, you know, you've got all these different platforms pulling you to advertise here and there, and still do DL drops and still go in the paper and still do newsletters. And what do you think would work? What would you do if you had 17 years experience?
I've got this one covered. I think it's a good question. It's not a hard question. The best way today, without a doubt, is social proof, right? So third-party endorsement. We're just sitting with Clinton could take over this. I'll throw it to him in a minute. But every time you get a result for a vendor, all right, you need to video it.
Yeah, you know, and you know what you say there, Matt. You know, it's so true, because one of the things that I'm trying to get my clients to do right now, and it, you know what it brought it home for me is we did in one of the episodes, and you were talking about, you know, your son Matt. Like today, we're in a culture and environment of reviews,
yeah,
where everyone reviews each other, right?
That's right.
And they want to hear it from the third party, not the actual agent or the agency that's doing it, whoever. They want to hear actually from the person that's been through that experience. So when I say do a video testimonial, I would say consider yourself to be the seller, okay? What would be the five top questions you could ask, right, you're in the video testimonial to the seller that just had an experience with you? So the first question could be is, what were your fears around selling? And you're not even in it, the question pops up and then they answer the question. They might say, well, we didn't know if we had to sell or not. And once we sat down with Jacquelynn, you know, she made us feel really comfortable about, you know, where the market was and what we needed to do to get our home ready for sale. So that because a seller there is looking going, that's the fears that we've got. And then is, what was the process did you use to select Jacquelynn and Ray White Freshwater? And they might say, well, we went to a few open homes and then we saw Jacquelynn at the auction down the road. And that really sort of set us our goal to work with Jacquelynn because she'd got an incredible result, and the way she worked the buyers and worked the floor, whatever it is. But you think of your top five questions that could relate. So what Maddie said, absolutely video testimonial. But think of the questions. If I was a seller and I'm thinking about appointing an agent, what could be that testimonial where that person's been through? And you got to capture that. Now, the next bit of thing, I'm not sure. Let's ask our friend and our third mentor here, Clinton.
Look, what you've just said makes a lot of sense to me actually with the video, because what I see, it's without sounding like Trump, God forbid, but I see a lot of fake news. I see a lot of statistics made up that people put on different portals
100%.
About how good they are. And I've actually seen people's friends Google reviewing their friends.
Happens all the time.
You know, and so everything that's written is really could be not 100% true. So I guess having a video taken of your vendor, you know, saying, well, this is what, as a testimonial, well, that's really good quality, honest proof.
Yeah.
And that would scream volumes. So that's really good. I'm probably going to start implementing that.
Jack, I would spend no other money doing anything else. Forget the DLs. They're just wasting, dropping trees down. Forget all the other stuff. I mean, it's all rubbish because at the end of the day, like, I'll give you a quick example, right? You've got kids, yeah?
Yeah, true. A
10-year-old
and a
5-year-old. Okay, all right. So my son's 19, right? So I learn a lot off my kids, that generation, 17 and 19. So my son wants to buy another car, new car, I should say, right? So he's only way of, like, he's following this guy on YouTube who's reviews cars, right?
Right.
So he won't even test drive it. He's already made his mind up from this guy that actually reviews the cars. He's not even looking at. I said, son, did you actually go and look at it in real life? He goes, oh no, I've seen a few of it. I said, did you sit in it? No. He goes, this guy, he knows everything, Dad, about cars. I said, to him, Luke, do you think this guy's getting paid by the motor vehicle company to tell you how good that?
No.
He's an independent reviewer, Dad. I've checked him out, right? I said, okay, Luke, that's all good, right? But you're just making a decision based on third party. And then this guy who's test driving these cars and saying how good it is and this is what it does, this is what it does, that guy goes out and interviews owners who have got the cars.
Yeah, right.
So my son's already, he's done. He's like, this is what the car has to get.
The third party person.
But he's never driven it, right? He's never even been to the car yard. He's never spoken to anyone who's driven one either, but he's made his mind up because this third party endorsement – He can't be swayed. Like I doesn't, you know, he thinks I'm out of touch. So he goes, you don't know, Dad, this is the way it is. You know, this guy, he's a specialist car reviewer. And he's probably right at the end of the day, right? But that's how the service is now getting picked up.
Exactly.
Right? Yeah.
It's so true. And even if, and maybe Clinton can share a little bit of this. And I know he's done that with some of his clients where document the journey of the sale of the property. So like over a 4-week see the open homes, bit of footage of the open home, a bit of footage of, you know, talking to buyers, a bit of footage going to the auction day, a bit of a snapshot, in, you know, not like a 15-minute auction, but just into 2 minutes, the result, the end. So people see...
So I did a live stream of our auction, which I had just towards the end of last year.
Yep.
And incredible. It got shared and it was great and the auctioneer was awesome It was really high energy, and I had quite a lot of great feedback from it, and a lot of views.
Yeah,
and that's not just saying, oh, we did really well at the auction, because I think every agent thinks that they've done really well.
Absolutely, it's true, but it's true.
You've got to get the vendor's testimonial.
Exactly. So documenting the journey of the sale, the video testimonials that we spoke about, right? But here's the thing: once you start, getting a collection of a video library, you know, and this is where we're heading. Right, and you're out there, but this is the this is where you're. This is what will give you the slight edge, Jack. 95% of the agents, right now, are thinking, dwelling, and pondering about social media. They're thinking about it.
I know,
and they're going, should I put my feet in it? You got to be the one. You put yourself out there. Everyone plays safe. Everyone plays safe. Like you know what? The guys who are winning in agencies today, real estate agents, are the ones who are playing offensive, not defensive.
And doing something different.
So true.
Doing something different. Yeah. They're all going, I'm going to get judged. My hair's not right. You know, the whole thing, have I got the right look?
I do get it. There is an element of you kind of go, like, up goes the camera or whatever. And you know, there's an element of like, oh, my gosh, how am I coming across? But it's like anything. It's new at the beginning, right?
Yep.
And then you've done it quite a few times.
Yep.
It becomes second nature.
It does. Exactly. Yeah. And we're always getting that fear about being judged. But at the end of the day, who gives it, like, you know, who really cares, right? So I want to bring Clinton into the conversation this morning as well, because I think, you know, he's got a lot of working with a lot of agents, right? And he's got a good grip on social media. So any tips that you could possibly give Jacquelynn. Also, I want to highlight too, Maddie, the point that she has got a lot of experience in the area.
Yep.
How can you push that as well? But just the social media bit, let's just cover that first with Clinton.
Yeah.
Hey, Jacquelynn, how you doing?
Yeah, good. How are you?
Going really, really well.
Yeah, good.
Exactly
what Claudio's saying, yeah.
Well, I've got a lot of thoughts around this. I think the number one thing people need to do before they even start doing social media is accept the fact that the best way to be unique is to be 100% yourself.
100%, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
That's where it starts. The second thing you have to do is you've got to be passionate about whatever it is you're doing. If you're not,
of course.
And you've also got to know yourself well enough to know if you're good at something or not. So some agents just aren't going to be great on camera. Like, that's just the reality of it. That's the truth of it.
Yeah.
Okay? It happens. But maybe you're better on the phone. Maybe you're better in person. Maybe
you're
better writing stuff. You know what I mean?
I've seen the people the same with the phone, you know. They're good on the phone. Some people aren't good on the phone. Some people are good, you know, negotiating. Some people aren't. You've got to find what you're good at and
spending on the phone. You're right. So once you get those two things right, you've then got to ask yourself the question, what's the end goal? Like, what am I actually wanting to achieve here? So when you were thinking, like, I didn't actually hear the question, I didn't have headphones on, but what was the, like, just really quickly in like 10 seconds, what's the initial question and what's the purpose of that question? Like, what are you wanting to achieve?
So I guess through social media, what I'm trying to achieve in the marketplace without coming across as an arrogant agent, what tools would you use and what would you do to be able to sell things such as your experience? So 17 years.
I wouldn't.
You know, selling and being through the market, which is like a GFC.
Yeah.
I think you get out there publicly, because I think now more than ever that what people are going to need to get that different, get that higher price.
Yep.
So, can I just say this really quickly?
What
would you do first?
Yep.
To get that message out there.
Easy. I wouldn't sell. First and foremost, and the reason I wouldn't do that is this is a branding game. Right, you've been in the market long enough now that you don't need to necessarily sell. The sell comes maybe later down the track, or the sell comes through the fact that you're just giving so much value that people want to do business with you.
Good point.
Really good point.
Okay. Yeah. So what that now looks like is if you want to brand yourself, you need to start documenting what you're doing and amplifying the things that are really good about what you do. Mm. So, to this point before...
Yeah, it's good. Great. It's really good.
Yeah, to this point before, you know how the guys were talking about, right, you need to get a testimonial.
Third party.
Mm. Third party.
Yep, totally.
The strategy here... Yeah, well, the whole point of it is you can't fake somebody's emotion when they've just bought or sold a property. You can't fake it. And so, like, if you're able to capture that moment, you can. Now, the beauty of it is, like, and this is what I said a year and a half ago that actually made me fall into this in the first place, is we've all got smartphones now. Like, gone are the days that you need to spend a shitload of money. I hope I can swear on the show.
Yeah. No, we love swearing.
We'll edit that bit.
But gone are the days where you need to go and spend a lot of money to be actual, like, to be actually, like, producing content. Now, if you want to go authentic, get that mobile phone out. Right? Get like a little microphone that you can attach to it. Go down to JB Hi-Fi, buy a Rode microphone that you can just plug straight into your phone and record it. Right? So I remember like a year and a half ago, we were doing stuff with Facebook Live. I was saying to agents, get onto Facebook Live because that's how you're going to reach more people. You know, the moment they sign the contract, pull your phone out and get them to have a chat to you and tell them about their experience. The problem. Right, so that's just one tactic.
Like, How simple is that, Jack? Yeah.
You could be doing Instagram stories. Like, Instagram stories is a good way of doing things now because a lot of people are paying attention to that. You got to think about where people are paying attention. But it's super important that you're not trying to fabricate or guide the client to say what you think they need to say.
If
you want to do this right,
And don't edit it, whatever the vendor says, the buyer says.
Yeah. Totally. Keep it authentic, keep it real.
You want to do, Jack, Clinton, you could probably potentially go out and do, I would do a proper testimonial first for yourself, a bit about you and your market, then some at the back of that video, add some quick commentary on that is not live necessarily, but there's past clients, like your top three past clients or anyone in your network as to why Jacquelynn Watson. Just ask the question, why Jacquelynn Watson?
Yeah. And even if some of those past clients that could have maybe you sold for 10 years ago, Jack, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
and they said, we've worked with Jacquelynn for the last 10 years. That's where the experience is going to come out, you know? And we've sold three homes with her, and every time she sold for us, like that would then people say, right, she has got the experience.
And then you can use that in your pre-listing kits. You said, owner says, why I'm coming to see you on Friday night or whatever of listing. You just say, look, I just send your video. And then I would get the owners to put, Clinton can superimpose their phone number onto the video. So like they can get the permission for the owners that they give their number out. So your next client can ring them direct and just check and have more of a conversation if they want. Does that make sense?
And it's very environmentally friendly with no paper needed.
It's an email.
Perspective as well.
Yep.
With putting the video, like just even recording it off your iPhone at the end of an auction.
I think what Clinton said, you can reach a whole lot of people with one push of a button versus this is why social media is so powerful.
Well, that's, you know, and we were just talking again about with another call before, like your social media, Instagram, you know, LinkedIn, Facebook, they're all like, that's your channels today, Channel 7, Channel 9, Channel 10, you know?
Yeah.
That's what everyone's, that's where everyone goes to. We spend over 50% of our day looking at our phone from emails to text messages to social media, right? So that's the place you got to be. But what I'd love for you to do, Jack, is like I said earlier, don't be that 95% of people or agents in this marketplace who are right now, like in your position, right? And they're thinking about doing it. Don't think. Just put yourself out there, okay? And I think that's what Clinton was saying is they're going to capture, you know, that experience from you when they're seeing stuff out there from you, okay? Rather than sell it to them, they'll feel it.
Jack, you got to look at it. The difference with DLs and letterbox drops and all that sort of fluff versus this
or everything else
is video is an investment because you can keep it and you can use it and use it and use it. And once you do a spray and pray letterbox drop, it's gone, it's done. So if you spend five grand a year on letterbox drops or $5,000 on video,
then you've got testimonials.
It's a video
online.
For life. You can keep using them in every situation.
You start a little video library, right?
I just want to add to this really quickly. So one thing I was going to say is a lot of people will go out and try to produce a production for a video piece of content, which works really well maybe 5 years ago.
But
to the point of authenticity, right, you can't beat documentation style. So I've had a couple of clients now where what we've done is we've gone out and we've followed them around for the whole day on a Saturday, and we've turned that into Yeah, we've turned that into a piece of content, right? And then literally a week later we go and we do like a presentation profile style video, and the dynamicness of it and the feeling they got after watching the first one versus the second one was totally different. They're like, oh, you know, like you've like literally the bar set too high because it's documentation is where it's working so much better.
Yeah, yeah, right. Very good. And you probably don't want to get too caught up in, you just want to do what you said originally is be yourself.
Good enough. Good enough is great.
Knowledge.
Not perfect. Yeah. Like, don't go for perfection. It's just make it good enough and do a lot of it.
It's good advice, Clinton.
Oh, well, awesome. Very exciting. Now I've just put myself out there.
You know the other thing, Jack, you've got, which a lot of agents don't have, because I've managed over, you know, up to 300 agents, I can tell you, is you got really good energy.
So, awesome energy. I love your
energy. I don't know if you even know you've got it, but I'm just telling you.
Yeah, lots of energy.
So, you know, people buy your energy. So the more, if you can sort of tie that into your social media that you're going to get out there on Saturday and work hard for vendors because you've got good energy, that's a huge advantage before you start.
Yeah, people buy energy, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, but Jacquelynn didn't tell you she was at the gym at 5 o'clock, got the kids organised for school, and now she's talking about
You're making me tired.
5 a.m. at the gym last night at 9 p.m. fitting it all in.
Good stuff. Oh my goodness.
All right. Hey, Jack, thanks so much for joining
us. Thank you guys so much. That's such amazing information for me, and it's inspired me to implement something like this now, and I will actually send you some things and show you.
Yeah, please. That's good. Well, you know, the success of every idea is in the implementation, yeah?
Absolutely, absolutely.
That's good. Have a lovely day.
You too, Jack. Later. And we look forward to seeing some of your posts, and we'd love to track your journey, how it's all going, okay?
Totally. Talk to you soon.
Thanks, Jack.
Take care.
Have a great day. Talk to you later. Bye.
Got something great from this episode? It would mean the world to us if you passed it on. Tune in each week as we mentor a new agent. Have a question? Want to be on the show? Get in touch with Claudio Encina, Matt LaHood, or visit our Facebook page. The Mentors is brought to you by Sprinklr.media.